So again, thanks for waiving the special rule for me. I've got Sam, John Quarterman, and Swanee Riverkeeper for the usual reason. Somebody had to do that. The April 10th meeting that Curtis is referring to, I think I sent you a note. There's videos of it that I took that are on YouTube. You can see the whole thing for yourself, including his excellent points. The rate they were going, I forget the exact number, but something like 162 years to get 10% done of everything outside the wastewater treatment plant.
I think that's what I told them, yes. Mm-hmm. So that was an improvement, brought it down by half.
Yeah.
Over there,
400. Yeah. But nonetheless, at that rate, they'll have it finished before they start breaking again at something like 40 years expected lifetime. So there's more work to do. And while everybody's in favor of the catch basin, I had a question which they didn't really answer. How do they know that catch basin is going to be big enough? What they told me was, well, they have a hydrologic report from Parsons Engineering of Atlanta that explains all that. It took several months for me to try that loose from them with an open records request. I have it on my own paper. As soon as I can get it scanned, I will make it available to you. Whether it really answers that question or not, I don't know yet. I'm hoping Tom Potter, our science committee chair, and some people like Mr. Purdy can form an opinion. There's also the issue of the those things that have been taking 162 years, that's the other third of what's spilled in December, not at the Wichita wastewater treatment plant. Many of waste locations are directly on creeks, which is an even more direct path to the river than from the plant. And some of those locations, such as at Lane Wright Road, which I mentioned every opportunity, has been leaking for years, to the tune of several hundred thousand gallons in December. Well, then someday they're going to fix those. That's what they're supposedly working on. And they hope to get another $40 million out of the SPLOST special local option sales tax that's going to be on ballot in November for both drinking water and wastewater. A related item is everybody wants to know, when is it coming from Georgia and is it really coming from that plant? And you all know Tom Frick with the FDEP. They asked for a meeting with Waterkeepers Florida. I don't know if y'all are familiar with Waterkeepers Florida. I'm probably the only waterkeeper you can see show up because I'm one for Swanee Basin. But there's actually 13 of us in the state of Florida, including, for example, St. John's Riverkeeper, Lisa Reinemann, whom you've probably run into. So FDEP asked for a meeting with Waterkeepers Florida about the triennial review, which, and you're no doubt aware, is every 3 years the federal government requires reviewing water quality standards. So we held that meeting down in Orlando. They actually drove from Tallahassee to Orlando to have a central location, I was impressed. And one thing that I found out from Tom Frick is FDEP is now working on doing DNA testing and testing for markers of human waste such as sucralose at least three locations, at the state line on Withcoochee and Yalapagoochee, and at the Withcoochee confluence on Swan. And I believe I got confirmation from Darlene Bellis over the telephone that is the case. Does that match what you've heard?
It's the Yalapagoochee, not the Yalapagoochee. Other than that, that's my understanding, yes. And that's part of their ongoing sample.
All right, okay. Which leads to two questions that I'm trying to resolve. One is how can we get that data in less than the 4 month interval it takes them to publish it? Not sure if indicated anything that would cause the Department of Health alert you would be willing to send earlier, but for purposes of watching what's going on, we'd really like to get the poll data earlier. The other thing was, he mentioned that there was some possibility that the district would be doing two more weeks of the month with similar monitoring, which I found very interesting. Now, I know you're doing excellent monitoring, including things like nitrates related to the fertilizer leaching, but he seemed to be indicating maybe the district was considering doing DNA and sucralose and such like markers. Do you know anything about that? Okay. Well, you just made my trip worthwhile.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't that, I don't, there's been no discussions with them of that, so perhaps you misread what he may have said, because that's, you know, it hasn't come up at this point. We would expect, you know, during, if we did do sampling, that we would coordinate with them so that we don't sample on the same day, so that if they were out there on the first of the month, we'd be out there 2 weeks later. But it would be our ongoing sampling. It would be DNA sampling, that's not in our plan.
Was it contest that you have seeking when you contact? Okay, well, that's why I always try to do, get confirmation of the thing I